Good morning. This is Pontangaram. I am working as an assistant professor in St. Martin Military College. Now I have to give the small demo on pollution. Okay. First, we have to know what is meant by pollutions. The pollutions, that one, how to define the pollutions. The presence of impurities or polluted substance in sufficient concentration level and causes harmful effect on human beings, animals, plant life or material resources. When exposed for a sufficient duration of time, the reducing the quality of life environments. That means increasing concentration of unwanted substance. The unwanted substance, that one is effect to the living organism, maybe plants, animals, and also effect to the properties also. Okay. Next one, there's the types of pollutions. How many types? That one is air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution, noise pollution, marine pollution, thermal pollution. These are the different types of pollutions. So first of all, what is the pollution? The process of increasing concentration of unwanted substance. For example, increasing concentration of unwanted substance in air, that one is air pollution. And increasing concentration of unwanted substance in soil, on the surface of the soil, that one is soil pollution and noise pollution. The sound is exposed. Sound is exposed in the environments. The sound is effect to the other living organisms. That one is noise pollution. Next one is marine pollution. Marine pollution means marine waters. Unwanted increase in concentration of increase concentration of any liquid chemical, solid chemical disposal into that one is in sea. See, that means the river waters. River water consists of number of impurities. The river water finally have to add to that one is sea waters. That one is increasing concentration of unwanted substance in sea water. That one is marine pollution and thermal pollution. Thermal pollution is water vapors. So temperature of water is increases. That one is effect to the aquatic animals. Okay, that one is different types of pollution. Different types of pollutions. Next. What is the pollutant? The pollution, the process of increasing of concentrations, the increase of concentration, that one is effect to the human beings, animals and property. The process is nothing but that one is pollution. But what is the pollutant? The pollutant is substance and energy introduced into the environment that are undesirable effect. Undesirable effect are adversely affect to the usefulness of the resources. A pollutant may be causes long or short term damage by changing the growth rate of that one is plants or animals. Is a long term process or a short term process? By the presence of that one is impurities, increasing concentration of unwanted substance. The substance may be gases, poisonous gases. The substance may be solid substance. Okay, the substance may be liquid substance. That one is maybe short term effect or long term effect. The which substance is affected by the other living organism? The substance is nothing but, that one is unwanted substance is nothing but pollutants. Next one is types of pollutant. That one is when the concentration of substance already present in nature or new substance increasing in the undesirable proportion, causing a damage to the humans. That one is effect to the human and also effect to that one is animals. That one is polluted. Actually, the unwanted substance present in natural in natures. Okay, naturally that one is formed. Contaminant, actually the substance which is does not occur in nature but is introduced by the activities, that one is human activity into the atmosphere affecting composition, is called as a contaminant. This pollutant, these are present in nature, but this pollutant actually this is not present in nature. That one is the creative, the activity are increased by the human being. Okay, that one is different between the pollutant and contaminant. Mainly definitions. We have to know that one is measurements of water resources also very very important. That one is dissolved oxygen, biological oxygen demand, chemical oxygen demand, threshold limit. First we have to know that one is dissolved oxygen. Dissolved oxygen, DO means that one is dissolved oxygen. The measurement of amount of oxygen dissolved in unit volume of water indicating of usefulness of the water for the specific applications. And the quantity of oxygen dissolved in water, that one is dissolved oxygen. Dissolved oxygen. Next one is dissolved oxygen saturation in fresh waters. is concentration. Concentration are increases. The concentration levels are increases. That one is dissolved oxygen. Dissolved oxygen concentration decreases. Why? Because in waters, water consists of dissolved oxygen. If temperature increases, that one is entered into the atmosphere. That one is the dissolved quantity of oxygen decreases in waters. For example, 0 degree centigrade. 0 degree centigrade. That one is, this is another foreign unit. 0 degree centigrade. That one is 14.6 milligrams per liter. This is the measurements of dissolved oxygen. Okay, five degree centigrade. What happens? That one is 12.8 milligrams per liter. 10 degree centigrade. That one 11.3 milligrams per liter. 15. That one 10.1 milligrams per liter. 20 degree centigrade. That one is 99.1 milligrams per liter. 25 degree centigrade. That one is 8.3. 30 degree centigrade, that one is 7.6 milligrams per liter. That means increasing of temperature, the dissolved oxygen in water are decreased. Dissolved oxygen decrease. Next one, chemical oxygen demand. The chemical oxygen demand, how to define the chemical oxygen demand? The chemical, that one chemical reaction purpose, we have to demand, that one is we have to involve the reactions, the oxygen from the waters. How to define that one is the amount of milligrams of oxygen needful to oxidize all organic compounds chemically in 1 liter of water. That means amount of oxygen required for chemical reactions in dissolved oxygen. Dissolved oxygen is a chemical oxygen demand. The chemical oxygen demand are often being as a parameter to determination of waste quality. For example, most unwanted waste substances, maybe solid waste, domestic waste, maybe industrial waste, agricultural waste, disposal into water bodies. What happened? This is a complex compound. This is a bulk, large compound. The decomposition purpose, that one is converted into small molecules. The decomposition purpose, we have to require that one is oxygen from this water. Next one is high level of chemical oxygen demand. That one is parameters of chemical oxygen demand influenced by the organic contaminant levels. For example, high level of that one is carbon dioxide. High level of that one is chemical oxygen demand. High level of that one is organic. High growth of microorganisms. The quality of waste is not good. Okay, the influences through that one is level of dissolved oxygen. Dissolved oxygen. Next one is what is the concentration? That one is moderate pristine. That one is river, the BOD level, that one is less than 1. Moderately polluted river, that one is 2 to 8 milligrams per liter. Ordinary domestic sewage, that one is 150 to 200 milligrams per liter. Next, municipal sewage, if efficiently treated, that one is more than 20 milligrams per liter. Okay, any effluents to be discharged into the natural bodies of water should have that one is biological oxygen demand less than the that one is 30 milligrams per liter. Next one, drinking water usually has a BOD of less than that one is 1 milligrams, but when BOD levels reaches to the 5 milligrams per liter, the water is doubtful in purity. Doubtful impurity. Next one is chemical oxygen demand. The chemical oxygen demand means the oxygen demand is measured of the amount of dissolved oxygen required to the break down the organic material in given volume of water through a anaerobic biological activity. That means in turbidity of waters, impure water consists of that only some microorganisms. Microorganisms also required that one is oxygen. If microorganism present in that water, if unwanted substance present in that water, the microorganisms, what is the role of the microorganism? That one is decomposed large size molecule into small size compound. That purpose, the activities are going on in the presence of that one is microorganism. In microorganism, for their growth, for their activity, how required oxygen from water. That one is biological oxygen demand. Biological demand, that one is BOD levels. What is the BOD level? That one is 1 to 2 ppm. Ppm, how to measure ppm or milligrams per liter? That one is 1 to 2 ppm. That one is very good.
they will not be changed organic present in the water supply. Next 3 to 5 ppm, that one is fine. Moderately, that one is clean. Next one is 6 to 9, that one is pure. Some water polluted usually indicate that one is organic matter is present and bacteria are decomposed. This is the waste. Next one is 100 or greater than more than 100, that one is very pure, that one is very very polluted, that contain that one is organic waste. If organic waste is present in that water, what happened? That one is biological oxygen demand values increases. Next one is air pollution. What is the air pollution? Air pollution means, it means that any solid, liquid or gaseous substance present in atmosphere in such a concentration as may be or trend to be injurious to the human being or other living creatures, plants or properties or environment, that one is air pollutant. Simply have to say that one is increasing concentration of unwanted substance. Increasing concentration of unwanted substance, the substance may be in the form of that one is solid substance, in the form of that one is maybe vapor, in the form of that one is particulate, dust particles present in air, that pollutant, that one is effect to the even plants, human being and also property. The process is nothing but that one is air pollution. But what is the air pollutant? The substance which creates the pollution is called as air pollutant. Okay. Air pollutant. Next, how to classification of that one is air pollution? How to classification of air pollution based on the origin? Next one, based on the state of matter. Next one is based on presence in environment. Based on the presence and origin, that one is primary pollutants. Next one is the secondary pollutant. Primary pollutant, secondary pollutant. Based on the state of matter, classified into two types: gases, air pollutant, and particulate air pollutant. Next one is based on presence in environment. That one is indoor air pollutant. Next one is outdoor air pollutant. These are the classification of air pollutant. Next, that one is classification based on the origin of pollutant, that one is primary pollutant and secondary pollutant. What is the primary pollutant? The emitted directly from the source that were found in that one is atmosphere in the form in which they are being emitted, like ash, smoke, dust and fumes, mist, spray, radioactive compounds in air, that one is primary pollutant. Any combustion of any substance, and combustion gives maybe some smoke and carbon particles, maybe oxides of carbon, oxides of nitrogen, oxides of sulfur into the atmosphere. Okay, directly combustion, that one is primary pollutant. What are the secondary pollutants? The secondary pollutants is are formed in atmosphere by chemical interaction between primary pollutant and atmospheric constituents, like that one is ozone formation, peroxide, nitrate, aldehydes and ketone. And primary pollutant, for example, carbon dioxide, oxides of sulfur, oxides of nitrogen, that one is reacts with water vapors to form acid rain. The formation of that one is acid rain. That one is ozone layer, that one is also ozone depletion. Peroxide, ethylene nitrate, aldehydes and ketone, these are the secondary pollutants. Next one is based on the state of matters. How to classify that one is gaseous pollutant and particulate air pollutant. Gaseous pollutant, that one is gaseous state. Particulate pollutant is nothing but solid state. Or gaseous pollutant, what are the examples? The gases, these are the pollutants are in gaseous state, like that one is fluorine, chlorine, that one is oxides of sulfur, oxides of nitrogen, this is gases pollutant. Next, particulate pollutant. The particulate pollutant, they are in suspended form in the atmosphere. These are in the form of that one is dust, smoke, fumes, along with the natural particulates like pollen grain, that one is volcanic dust and fungal sporant, that one is protozoa. This one is particulate pollutant. Okay, next one is based on the biological origins. Based on the biological origins, again classified into that one is two types. that one is biodegradable pollutants and non biodegradable pollutant. What are biodegradable pollutant? Those which are readily decomposed by the natural process. Natural process by the microorganisms. In presence of microorganisms, that one is domestic sewage. Domestic sewage, that one is example for the biodegradable pollutant. Next one, non-biodegradable pollutants that are readily very slow into the natural environment. Natural, the decomposition purpose required more amount of time. And these compounds are not decomposed by microorganisms. That one is non-biodegradable pollutants. What are the examples? That one is plastic. Plastic, that one is aluminium cans, glass and DDT, dichlorodiphenyl, trichloroethane, mercuric salts. These are the example for the biodegradable pollutants. Okay, that one is entire classification of air pollutions. Thank you very much.